5, 4, 3, 2, 1. However, before exercise of such power, the High Court must have due regard to the nature and gravity of the crime. Heinous and serious offences of mental depravity or offences like murder, rape, dacoity, etc. cannot be fittingly quashed even though the victim or victim's family and the offender have settled the dispute. Such offences are not private in nature and have a serious impact on society. Similarly, any compromise between the victim and the offender in relation to the offences under special statutes like the Prevention of Corruption Act or the offences committed by public servants while working in that capacity, etc., cannot provide for any basis for quashing criminal proceedings involving such offences. But the criminal cases having overwhelmingly and predominantly civil flavor stand on a different footing for the purposes of quashing, particularly the offences arising from commercial, financial, mercantile, civil, partnership or such like transactions, or the offences arising out of matrimony relating to dowry, etc., or the family disputes where the wrong is basically private or personal in nature and the parties have resolved their entire dispute. In this category of cases, the High Court may quash the criminal proceedings if, in its view, because of the compromise between the offender and the victim, the possibility of conviction is remote and bleak, and continuation of the criminal case would put the accused to great oppression and prejudice, and extreme injustice would be caused to him by not quashing the criminal case despite full and complete settlement and compromise with the victim. In other words, the High Court must consider whether it would be unfair or contrary to the interest of justice to continue with the criminal proceeding, or continuation of the criminal proceeding would tantamount to abuse of process of law, dispute, settlement and compromise between the victim and the wrongdoer, and whether to secure the ends of justice, it is appropriate that the criminal case is put to an end, and if the answer to the above questions is in the affirmative, the High Court shall be well within its jurisdiction to quash the criminal proceeding. Perusal of the record reveals that the dispute between the parties is basically a matrimonial dispute, and the offences is purely a private offence, and the offences involved in this case are not heinous offences, nor there is a serious offences of mental depravity. Rather, the same has resulted from a marital discord between the petitioner number 1 and opposite party number 2. Because of the compromise between the offenders and the victim, the possibility of conviction is remote and bleak, and continuation of the criminal case would put the accused petitioners to great oppression and prejudice, and extreme injustice would be caused to them by not quashing the criminal case despite full and complete settlement and compromise with the victim. इस वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में इस पैसेज का टेक्स्ट दिया हुआ है।